within the unity that used to prevail in this challenge to be retained and maintained in Jesus' name. I pray for
Thank you. répéter sur mon colo mon nom, c'est de tirer ma trace au colo. Répéter sur mon colo mon nom, c'est. Répéter sur mon colo mon nom, c'est de tirer mon colo, c'est de laisser. Répéter sur mon colo mon nom, c'est de tirer. Yes, praise God. Yeah. Oh, the Lord is here. I can feel His presence. I can feel His power. And I'm telling you that you don't leave this place as you came. Because the Lord is going to turn everything around for your favor in Jesus' name. You believe it? Yeah. Then we shall fire!
Fire!
Fire! Today I was to teach something else, but the Lord has just shifted my sermon as I was praying with you this morning here. Yes, and the Lord is just telling me to tell you what He's doing amidst you. Are you ready to know what He's doing amidst you?
Yes.
The Lord told me that He's going to do 4 things to you today, not only today, but now. Do you believe that you're receiving your miracle now?
Yes.
Because you're serving a God of the now.
Yes.
Yes, omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent. He is there with you now.
Amen.
He knows what you're passing through. Remember, He never sleeps, He never slumbers. In Jesus' name, may He work in your life now.
Amen.
May He restore you now.
Amen.
May He be money to your needs.
Amen.
May He be money to your debt.
Amen.
May He be health to your sickness.
Amen.
May He be health to your ailment. May He be discipline to your children.
Amen.
May He be honor to your church,
Amen.
To your ministry.
Amen.
Receive it.
I see.
Receive it.
I see.
My whole concept of what's been killing me so long. Now I want to unleash what the Lord has told me today that He's going to do unto your life. Number one. Remember the Lord said somewhere that I will remember all the days that the locust has eaten. It is the Lord speaking now. The Lord is telling me to tell you that He will remember the days that the locust has eaten. Yeah, the Lord is remembering those days now. Because when the locusts were busy eating your days, when the locusts were busy wasting your time, the Lord was still God. He was still seated in His golden throne, surrounded by cherubs and seraphims, praising His name, shouting and chanting, "Holy, holy is your name, the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of your glory." Yes, as you are seeking God in truth and in spirit, going to church every Sunday, fasting and praying, the Lord is saying today that He's remembering these things and He's remembering these days. They were not wasted. Any investment from God can never decay, can never be stricken by rust. Because the Lord that we serve is a God of restoration. May He restore you. May you be restored.
Amen.
In your family, restored.
Amen.
In your marriage, be restored.
Amen.
In your prayer life, be restored.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, Bakolo, Mosetor, Mose, the Tele, Beso, Bolose, Balose, Beretor, Sere, the Keso, Botero, Bokoso, Bole. Let us go to the book of Leviticus, chapter 26, verse 9. Bakolo, Masero, Botero, Bokoso, Bole. Ore, Balase, Beretor. Oh, I can feel too much power. Jesus is passing today. I will respect Him. Shout, tell your neighbor, the Lord will respect you today.
The Lord will respect you today.
Hey, my sermon today, 4 things that the Lord is doing. That is my theme, my topic today. 4 things that the Lord is going to do unto your life today. You know, I was supposed to preach about some 4 things through another sermon. But here comes another sermon that the Lord has just released when I was standing in this pulpit. Yeah, the Lord is going to respect you today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Doesn't matter which shame you are passing through. Doesn't matter who is despising you outside there. Doesn't matter what names are people calling you outside there. What the Lord is telling me to tell you this morning is, He's going to respect you. Yes, makolo bo setoro hase makele beso bolosi. Ule paso bo kolo bo setoro hoso bo kolo base berete. Doesn't matter what you have passed through. Doesn't matter which level you reach in your education curriculum. What matters today is what the Lord is talking about your life today. About your life this hour, this minute, this second, that is going to respect you. May the Lord respect your ministry.
Amen.
The Lord respect your church.
Amen.
May the Lord respect your spiritual leaders.
Amen.
May the Lord respect your children.
Amen.
May the Lord respect your husband.
Amen.
And may the Lord respect your wife.
Amen.
Doesn't matter what is ailing you. Doesn't matter what you're passing through today. Doesn't matter who is hating you, who is pointing a finger at you. Doesn't matter who is judging you. The Lord says that He's going to respect you in Jesus' name. Oh, those who have given you ultimatums, those who have drawn lines of limitations in your life, I'm telling you today, they're going to be ashamed, because out of that greatness, there is greatness in you, and that greatness is respect from God. You better be despised by the people you see with your naked eyes and be respected by God. And may the Lord respect you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Lord respect you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That is what matters in your life. What matters in your life is respect from God.
Amen.
The Bible says, and there was this man whose name was David. David was the last born in his family. David was nothing but just a shepherd, a class 2 dropout shepherd, somewhere in the bush. He knew nothing about the outside world. What he knew was bush, milk, and stench from goats and sheep. But the Bible says, and this man used to praise God. He was a harpist. He used to praise God with a harp. That was what God invested in him before he was formed in his mother's womb. And David didn't ditch his ministry. He didn't look at the despise that people used to despise him with. David saw himself as a hero before the eyes of God. He used to praise God, and nothing but praising God. But the Bible says, and out of that great mess, that people thought that David's life was in a mess, the Lord respected him. Wow. No connection. No respect, even from his siblings, even from his family members. He was segregated, isolated, and rejected. But the Bible says that out of that mess, the Lord took him out of sheep flock to the palace. To the palace. When he was in the battlefield, he met one of the most celebrated warriors in the field of military science, who was the greatest intimidator in the Bible. Yeah, the greatest intimidator in the Bible is meeting the greatest intimidated person in the Bible, who is David. But that intimidation was through sons of men's eyes, I'm telling you. There are some battles in your life that you may look an amateur. There are novice. Yeah, there are some issues in your life you may look like an underdog. Let me put it that way. Yes, because you don't qualify. But remember, those are just eyes of sons of men. Those are not eyes of God. The Bible says that His ways are not like our ways. The way He speaks, the way He walks, the way He thinks, the way He reasons, the way He looks unto you, is not the way sons of men looks unto you. Not the way you look unto yourself. Yes, like the skies are high above the sky. That's how great His... Oh, le pastor for Colobasi de Rete. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Oh, may the Lord respect you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Lord respect you in the presence of your Goliath in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Lord give you honor in the presence of your Saul in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, your King Saul must bow down to the respect that the Lord has respected you with in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And may it happen now.
Amen.
Receive it now.
Amen.
Receive it now. In Jesus' name, receive it. Because the Lord has said that He's going to show you respect. He's going to respect you.
Amen.
Don't worry. In whose presence the Lord is going to respect you. Just think about the respect that the Lord is giving you today, as at this time, in your modus operandi. Do you believe that you have received that respect in Jesus' name? Amen. That's the first thing that the Lord has done in your life.
Amen.
It is not in vain that you have been praying. It is not in vain that you have been giving your tithes and offerings. Not in vain that you have been coming to church every Sunday. Not in vain that you have been paying your fare, coming to this place to worship God. The Lord never forgets the good things that you do unto Him. Number two, the second thing that the Lord is going to do unto your life this morning, and make you fruitful. The Lord is going to make you fruitful. The Lord is going to make you fruitful. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I'm saying that the Lord is going to make you fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Lord make you fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Lord make you fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Fruitful in your finances.
Amen.
Fruitful in your family.
Amen.
Fruitful in your ministry.
Amen.
Fruitful in your faith.
Amen.
Receive fruitfulness in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May you receive your prophetic concern in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May you receive your magic from the east, laden with gold,
Amen.
To take you out of poverty in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It doesn't matter who is standing in your way. It may be a witch in the village. It may be an envious neighbor where you live. But I'm telling you this morning that the Lord is going to make you fruitful.
Amen.
Doesn't matter what is hurting you. Doesn't matter what is stabbing you. What matters what the Lord says. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah that when the Lord opens a door, who can close it? When the Lord says something, who can oppose it?
Amen.
When the Lord commands, even the devils obey.
Amen.
There's any devils or demons that's holding your blessings. May they obey by releasing those blessings unto you and live your life completely in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because today you are receiving your liberation.
Amen.
Today you are receiving your freedom.
Amen.
You are receiving your liberty.
Amen.
Not by might, not by strength, but by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Receive it.
Receive
it. Receive
it.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
May you be fruitful.
Amen.
May you shout, I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
I can't hear you.
I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
You will not know how to shout. Yeah? I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
You know, in the speech of Yahweh, words, things that you speak, you confess with your tongue, yes, are very legal. And those are the things that makes you a somebody. You know, the spiritual realm is not like in the logic world, in the logic realm. The logic realm is the realm of reason. Yes, maisha yako ya sahili una reason. Yeah? Niko na unga quarter. Nikipika hii quarter, nipike quarter ya quarter. Na quarter ya quarter naikula for 3 days. That is logic. Isn't it? Praise God.
Amen.
And that is your natural reason. Yeah? You are reasoning with your mind. Isn't it? The wrong is going pastor, because I'm a pastor in my scheme. Yeah? That's the reason. Amen?
Amen?
But faith is something that looks like madness when it comes to reason. Isn't it?
Yes.
And faith is, I don't want a job because of God. The church I'm going to can't pay me. But that's the church that I will worship in. I'm not shifting my church, but I'll just be fruitful in that church. And how am I going to be fruitful? I'm not going to do any business, any job, because I'm not called to do that. Yes, I'm just going to serve God with these 66 books that I'm carrying in my hands. Well, that's what people say, hey, this man is mad, though. You're running out of your mind. How dare you think that you'll be fruitful without reason? And like I stuffed a gazi banana, watch I'm chasing, isn't it? That's the reason, eh? Reason, that's why I'm normally telling you people that the flesh can never do the will of God. If you want to do the will of God, anytime you go before the Lord, you have to cut off your flesh completely. Yes, and tell God, I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. And the words that you speak are what become sense in your life. Yes, those are the words that can make you, not break you. The power of life and death is in your tongue. That's the slogan that is used in the spiritual realm. What you speak becomes legal. What you speak becomes a reality. But when the Lord tells you that I will make you a millionaire, if you don't say aye, it is even if Atakama Mungu will make it is impossible. What will happen to you? He will respond by telling you, now you will see and you will not eat. And that's what happened during that AIDS king in the story of Elijah. Is it Elijah or Elisha? Elijah, isn't it? Praise God. He saw it, but never tasted it. And that's why many believers are losing it in life. Yes, you are reasoning too much. That faith, faith is the substance of things hoped for. Yes, if you want to be fruitful, shout it out. If you want to be a blessed person, shout your blessings out. But if you block them inside you, they will rot inside and they will never manifest. So shout that I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
I'm fruitful in Jesus' name.
Hey, John, may you be fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You got to go up. Clap for John. Or not clap for yourself. Yeah, praise God. Amen. The spirit of realm is just a realm of confession, of speaking and believing. Not a realm of going to school, getting papers, getting a heap of papers, calling themselves degrees and academic credentials, and maneuvering in your careers, yeah? Through your deep logic mind. No, the spiritual realm never works that way. It works the opposite from the logic world. Yes, you think that you are too old to achieve. You think that you are too illiterate to become a president. You think that you are too rejected. You are too rejected. Yes, to be accepted, not to be a celebrity. You think that you don't even have friends to walk around with. But I'm telling you, you have a friend who is Jesus Christ. That's why someone sang a song called entitled, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." If you are a friend of Jesus Christ, you are being backed up by billions of angels. That's why the Bible says that when he overcame the devil, the angels came to minister unto him. And I'm telling you, when they reject you, remember that those who are on your side are numerous and greater in number than those whom you are seeing. They're magnificent in glory than those whom you are seeing. So don't worry to walk alone. Don't worry to be rejected. Don't worry to be outsmarted. Just worry about walking with God and being positive in God and confessing truthfulness wherever you go. And the Lord told this man called Adam and Eve. He blessed them and told them, go and be fruitful. So that seed of fruitfulness is in you. It doesn't matter which school you went to. It doesn't matter whom you are connected to. That seed is in you. I'm sweating too much. That thing that the Lord is telling me that is going to do in your life, I'll multiply you. May the Lord multiply you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord is not going to add you. He's not going to divide you. He's not going to subtract you. But he's going to multiply you.
Amen.
Do you believe that you are receiving your multiplication in your life?
Yes.
And this love in your family, may we receive it. May it be multiplied in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the grace in your ministry, may it be multiplied in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because the Lord is going to do it. It is not by your mind, it is not by your reasoning, but by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
May we receive your multiplication.
Amen.
Yes, in your mind receive it.
Amen.
In your health receive it.
Amen.
In your ministry receive it.
Amen.
In your job receive it.
Amen.
Oh, in all areas of your life, may we receive it.
Amen.
Receive it.
Amen.
Receive it! And the Lord told Adam, be fruitful and multiply. That seed of multiplication is in you.
Amen.
It is in you already.
Amen.
But now I'm telling you that the Lord is activating it now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Receive it.
Amen.
May the Lord activate it now.
Amen.
May the Lord activate that seed of multiplication.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
All the dreams of multiplication you ever dreamt,
amen,
may the Lord activate them now.
Amen.
May the Lord manifest that now.
Amen.
May the Lord manifest them now.
Amen.
May they manifest now.
Amen.
May they manifest now.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Manifest.
Amen.
Manifest.
Amen.
Manifest.
Amen.
And John and Patmos in the book of Revelation chapter 21, verse 1. The Bible says, and John saw the new world and the new sea, because the former world was not there anymore. So may you see the new world.
Amen.
Amen. And the new waters.
Amen.
Full of multiplication.
Amen.
Full of purity and parity.
Amen.
Without any demonic penetration or perforation.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You see it now.
Amen.
You receive it now.
Amen.
You receive it now.
Amen.
All the Bible says that be anxious for nothing, but in everything, in prayers and supplication and thanksgiving, let your matters be known unto God. So today, we are not being anxious for anything, because the Lord is speaking great things in our lives.
Amen.
Because the Lord is speaking multiplication in your life.
Amen.
Because the Lord is speaking fruitfulness in your life.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The last thing. And establish my covenant with you.
Amen.
I repeat, and establish my covenant with you.
Amen.
It is not ancestral covenant.
Amen.
It is not magical covenants. It is a covenant that magicians, yes, made to destroy your life. It is not those magic, those covenants. It is not the covenant of demonic and evil ancestors who wallows and whispers in your family tree to ruin and destroy your life. It is not those covenants. It's the covenant of God, the Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Amen.
The covenant that says, I'll be a blessing to those who are a blessing to you.
Amen.
The covenant that says, I'll be a curse to those who are a curse unto you.
Amen.
The covenant that says, I will make you prosperous.
Amen.
Yes, and I will enrich you. And I will, the covenant that says, that in my stripes, you are healed.
Amen.
The one that says, in my wounds, your transgressions are forgiven.
Amen.
The covenant that says, in your chastisements, yes, are your peace.
Amen.
The one that says, in your bruises, yes, bruises normally form scars when they heal. Yes, and today I'm telling you, the so-called scars, you are going to celebrate them, because when you celebrate your scars, the Lord cast them to become stars.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will never create stars in heaven for you.
Amen.
Don't pray for stars in heaven. No, those are just chemicals you have seen in heaven. A bunch of chemicals combined together, yes, by force of gravity, form stars in the heavens. Isn't it? So what are the stars that the Lord says that He will release unto you? Are the stars that are coming or that came from your bruises and wounds? And the stars that are inside you from your emotional wounds, yes, and physical wounds, from your chastisement, to spoil, to rebuke, those people who rebuked you, yes, those people who despise you because of lack, because of poverty. Yes, the Lord is going to turn all these things around to become stars that will shine wherever you go, in
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Why? Because the Lord gave you power of creativity. The Bible says that those who believe in Him are given power to become the children of God. Who is this children of God? Who is this child of God? Our firstborn is Jesus Christ. So we are Jesus Christ's brothers. Jesus Christ is our firstborn. So we have that power of creativity. Because the Bible says that in the beginning, yeah, the people of God was hovering in the face of the deep. Yeah, the Lord said, let there be light. And that one that He said was Jesus Christ. Because that one became flesh and dwelt amidst us. So that power of creativity is in you. If you say that I want to be fruitful, it will happen. You know that I want to be multiplied, it will happen. If you say that God, the pain that is haunting me, the pain, that's what happened to Jabez. Jabez said, and when people used to see Jabez, they used to see pain, suffering, struggle, poverty, and confusion. Why? Because when his mother begot him, he begot him out of suffering and pain. And he called his name Jabez, which means pain. So the Bible says, in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 9, the Bible says that, and Jabez called upon the name of the Lord and said, God, this pain is too much unto me. May you bless me and expand me indeed. He didn't pray a long prayer, just a short prayer, but in the presence of God. Today, I'm just praying a short prayer, but in the presence of God, which will turn everything around in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Just one divine touch of God Almighty can change everything in your life.
Amen.
Yes, can heal you, your sicknesses, can promote your life and can give you a peaceful job. Yes, a job, an income generating job, that when you woke up in the morning and going to eat, you feel like, hey, I just missed that job. Yeah? You don't feel like quitting. You don't feel like coming out of that job. You feel like going. Compared to that person who says that, hey, as we figure something. There was a day I used to work in the airport. Offloading. But airport, in the airport. So go to airport, nakimzana masaya day. You know, ndege iko na masaya. Ikiamka chini inataka kulipa taxes. So nikitoka, kwa hiyo masaya iko hapo, italipa taxes mpaka itatoka. So kama ni saa tano na nusu itatoka. Kazi yenyewe inafaa kuifanya saa tano na nusu. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Ndio mzigo ndio kwa ndege ni kama hii building yote kutoka chini mpaka juu. Isn't it? Look, is it true?
Yes.
Yeah. We have to forget ndege kidogo. Praise God. Yes, ndege ndio kwa building hii building kutoka chini mpaka juu. Zinaingia ndani ya ndege, I'm telling you. Yeah? So, kama ni 30 minutes ya ndege iko hapo, mtahakisha hiyo mzigo yote. Eh? Ibi mbili yote ni kisa ndani yeo ndege. Praise God.
Amen.
So, that job was cumbersome. Eh? Not that you're really a kasofti. You know I'm a kasofti kind of person. Praise God. So, tumora sikia ndege ina shuka huko chini. Ikishuka chini, tunaanza kuingia. Nasema, hey! Kuna kuna rungina wakia na ndege wana fly because they are going to a crowd, they are going to enjoy themselves. Sili kwa ndona ndege tunalia. Sili kwa ndona ndege tunalia. Jumbo jet from where? From Britain. Why? Because we know the pain that you are going through. But this mwana ndege inaenda, but you don't know the people who work behind that ndege. Praise God.
Amen.
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 Well, so, naomba ndege yako isiwe kilio, iwe furaha, eh? Ndio kwa first class, eh? Isn't it?
Amen.
Isiwe kilio. Unataka nikwambia watu wengine wanasema watu wengine waomba Mungu nasaidie nipate ndege. Mungu sisi tulikuwa tunasongea ndege but tunalia. Sasa ndio ndio tulikuwa tunaomba kwa kanisa tupande. Praise God. Tusawa, hiyo ndio kuna ndani sana. Eh? Tusawa ni sakas, but tusawa ni sablessing. So today, I want to turn everything in your life to become a blessing.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
That job you are doing may be a blessing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That family that you are on may be a blessing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your wife, your children, your neighbors, everything that is connected to you, may it be a blessing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And that the prayer that best made, may you turn the pain to be a blessing.
Amen.
May not turn your pain to be blessings.
Amen.
Your children are not going to be pain anymore.
Amen.
They're not going to be pain in your emotional wounds. They're not going to be pain that forms emotional wounds in your life again in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes, you have to celebrate your children in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have to celebrate them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have to celebrate your wife in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have to celebrate your siblings, your relatives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Not being put in that family to be an enemy to your relative. They did not put you in that charge to be an enemy to that church member. They don't put you to that church, that family, that ministry, that job, so that you be a blessing unto them.
Amen.
That's what the Bible says, that whenever Christ went, yes, he did good.
Amen.
That means he was a blessing from each land that his foot is he put his step unto. Even the demonic land of Gadarenes, yes, became a blessing there. Yes, they chased him. They said that, no, we don't need you here. Just pack your skirts and take off. Yeah, he took off, but left a blessing there.
Today,
from now, wherever you go, may you be remembered by the blessings that you leave behind.
Amen.
Yes, if Christ was not remembered by the chastisement he received at the seizure of Gadarene, he remembered by the miracle he did at Gadarene. A lot of people don't know that Christ was chased away in Gadarene. Do you know that? Yeah, he was chased in the Bible. But what people remember is, yes, I don't know what I'm saying, isn't it? Yes, I'm going to see what I'm saying, I'm going to see what I'm saying, and I'm going to see what I'm saying, and I'm going to you remember that, isn't it? Amen. So may you be remembered because of the good things that you ever did in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Even those people who hate you, even those people who mock you, today, from today, I want them to start remembering you with the good things that you ever did unto them. And if you have never done anything good unto them, may the Lord create that avenue. May the Lord create that chance for you to do something good unto them. So that when they curse you, they may be rebuked by that good deed you ever did unto them, or you are just about to do unto them, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Why? Because the Lord is remembering His covenant with you. The covenant of blessings, the covenant of elevation, of promotion, the covenant that says it is not good for a man to be alone or a lady to be alone, they must get married. May that covenant be remembered unto you. Who will receive your wife, who will receive your husband,
amen,
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Do not say that children are what? Are like security to the old age. Oh, that covenant of receiving a child, conceiving a child, may it be remembered unto you wherever you are, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Do not say that I'll be held because out of my stripes, you are healed. So if there is any sick person amidst us, may God remember that covenant of health and release that health unto you. For those who are in medication, the Lord remember you and be a medication to your health in Jesus.
Amen.
Are you receiving what I'm saying?
Yes.
Are you receiving what I'm saying?
Yes.
May you stand. Jesus is passing government official, but I can see his face. He's a person that I know. He's a person who is in police force. He's a senior police officer, and I can see that this person is connecting us to Italy, and that person is releasing, and that connection
we release a lot of money. I've needed stars. Let me not use these. So that Gaza will not attack us. So we're going to Gaza. Amen.
Amen.
So this is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing a man who is a senior government official. And this person I know is my friend, yeah? But this person can just be a symbol, isn't it? Yes. So I can see that this person is connecting us to Italy. And out of that connection, can you hear me, Onyuma?
Yes.
And that connection is going to release a lot of money. Yeah? A ministers. And that money will belong to this ministry. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
So what does that mean? It means that there is a higher connection that is coming. You know, Italy represents Rome, Roman Empire. Yeah? Is it true? A Roman Empire is the European Union. Isn't it? There is Germany, Italy, Spain, France, and those countries, and the European Union community. Is it true?
Yes.
So that means there is a connection that God is connecting us to Europe. Yeah?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But it is my prayer. Yeah? It is my prayer that, okay, let the will of God be done. But according to me, it is my prayer that if that connection comes, let it come as a connection that is coming to tap the anointing that the Lord has released and lead us. Not a connection that will come from proposals or begging for their alms. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
But then the will of God be done. Yeah? That is according to me as a human being. But let the Lord do what he wants to do. Amen?
Amen.
Because his ways are not like our ways. Then I'm seeing that there are some people who left us. And there are some people who are here who are planning to leave us. Isn't it? So, where they are going, I can see that there's a road that they are walking. Something like a road, yeah? And in this road, it's headed into darkness. And there is someone here whom I'm seeing. I don't want to mention their name. Yes? But that road, there is darkness ahead. There's a road sign written, darkness ahead. So I saw that person going, and that person remembered Tony and said, I have to go back to where Tony is. Yeah? So I see these people who left us trying to come back through the same road because where they were heading to, they were towards darkness. So they came back. So, but the vision ended up without them seeing or not locating where our church was. So, it's true the Lord has remembered some covenants that he established amidst us. Amen.
Amen.
Those who have ears, let them hear what the Spirit is telling the church. There are some delays that we have been experiencing. Now I'm prophesying, yeah? So take it very serious. And these delays are there, or were there, with a reason. I've been seeing, trying to ask God, why is it that you promised us that things will come? We ended up not seeing these things happening. Then you later tell us that it is some magicians or some prognosticators of darkness who have done these deals not to materialize. So the Lord told me that it had a reason behind it. And the Lord is telling me to tell you that all the days that the locust ate, he's going to restore.
Amen.
Because it's only God who can restore what locusts has eaten. And the Lord is telling him, that he's going to take us out of this place. Yeah? Yes, and I'm seeing another church somewhere besides the Lord. And it will start like a something like a tent. You know, a tent can be a mabati, isn't it? I think this prophecy has ever at once come past in this place, yeah? Isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, and some people have been seeing this church. It's not, it's in form of a mabati, something like a mabati or tent. That's where we are going to start. And that church will be fireful. There's some people who will just live in that church. Have you ever seen people living in a church?
Yes.
Yeah? We pray, we pray with them. People will be living in that church. Yeah? They will be too much into that church to the extent of being called fanatics. A fanatic is someone who follows something without reason. Isn't it? So let us raise fanatics of God Almighty. That is to the logic world. Amen. We see that some people will even sacrifice their family. Yes? Yeah, it will bring even commotion in some families. Because people will leave their wives. Wives will leave their husbands. Children will leave their parents and come to live in that church. Because of what the Lord is doing amidst us. These are the covenant that the Lord is remembering. And the Lord is doing amidst us.
Amen.
We have been praying for God to remember our covenants, yeah? And now He's remembering them in a mighty way. Amen. The Lord is telling me, yes, we were crushed occasionally. We have been crushed. Sometimes the church is growing, sometimes it's fading, it's growing, it's fading, yeah? But the Lord is telling me to tell you that we were never destroyed. And nothing can destroy us.
Amen.
Because we are unshakable.
Amen.
Why? Because the Lord is amidst us. And when the Lord is on our side, who can be against us? Is these prophecies a reminder of the prophecies that once passed through this pulpit? I think I see myself as repeating myself, yeah? Amen.
Amen.
But this is what the Lord is telling me to tell you. So there is something great that the Lord is just about to do amidst us. Don't give up. Don't give up. Amen.
Amen.
So if you think that your ways are not straight, make your way straight. A time has come that you have to elevate your faith. Yes, and start thinking about this good God and of end time gospel mission. Amen.
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 Am I making sense to someone?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord is reminding me today to remind you. Let us not dance out seeking anointings and miracles from any other altar apart from the altar that the Lord has connected you to. Because each altar is used by God Almighty differently. The Lord is a God of varieties. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not saying that those altars are demon possessed. No. The Lord connected you to this altar with a reason. Amen.
Amen.
So if you go to another altar, you are reversing yourself. Go to connect that altar. Then if you leave that altar, you go to another one, you reverse yourself. Go to connect that altar. So you'll be reversing and connecting, reversing and connecting, plugging and unplugging, plugging and unplugging. That is my timing. Yeah? So just learn to stay in the same place until you receive what you came to receive in that place. When the grace of separation comes to happen, we will just separate without any struggle. Amen? But wait until you receive your blessing. Wait until you receive your miracle. Yeah? If that miracle will be too big for you to settle in one place, no problem. We'll just part ways. But at peace. Am I making sense?
Yes.
Let those who has ears, let them hear what the Spirit is doing. What?
Say,
I think I'm done. Let us die. My time is over. Praise and worship God for.
I surrender.
I surrender.
Hallelujah.
I surrender.
I surrender.
The Lord of hosts, from now henceforth, I want to surrender this pulpit and you. If there is any demonic representation, confusion, no urgency that will dare try to work against this pulpit, deal with it according to your way. In Jesus' name. Because you are a perfect God. Jehovah Lord, you have said that you will expand us, you will multiply us, you will make us fruitful, and you will establish your covenant with us. May it come to pass in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May it come to pass in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because you have said, do it, Jehovah Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Do it in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
No more waiting. Do it, Jehovah Lord.
Yes.
No more delay. Do it, Jehovah Lord.
Yes.
Do it, Jehovah Lord.
Yes.
Do it, Jehovah Lord.
Yes.
You are a working wonder miracle, God. You want to see your miracle. If anyone amidst us is sick, Jehovah Lord, may you come and do something remarkable in their health.
Amen.
It doesn't matter which sickness is striking them. What matters is your power and the visitation of your healing power, whatever your people have. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I surrender.
I surrender all.
Hallelujah.
I surrender.
I want to declare and decree a blessing unto the hearts that are raised in Jesus' name. From now henceforth, may anything that this hand touch turn into gold and silver in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If this hand have ever given anyone money and that person be with that money to become a curse, and that this person, and that lady, that child, oh Jehovah Lord, I reverse that curse and I release a blessing.
Yes.
I release a blessing.
Amen.
All the projects that this hands, that came from this hands, or that you bless this hands to do, it may be projects of miracle, of performing miracles, signs and wonders. It can be projects of business. It can be projects of blessing people's life and changing their lives economically. Yes, I restate them, and establish that covenant now through the mighty name of Jehovah Sabaoth in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want these hands to shine. I want these hands to shine.
Amen.
No matter whichever the thing that the devil stole in these hands, I restore it now.
Amen.
I restore it now.
Amen.
Whichever thing the locust has eaten in this land, I restore it now.
Amen.
I restore now.
Amen.
Restoration.
Amen.
Restoration.
Amen.
Restoration.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May we remember all the tithes, offerings that these hands have ever given. And may you bless them. Indeed, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is said that the more Moses raised his hands up, the more the Israelites won the battle. The more they are raising these hands up, the more they are winning their battles.
Yes.
The more they are outsmarting the forces of gravity. The more they are attracting the adhesion forces of elevation. The forces of ascension. Ascension to your glory.
Amen.
Ascension to your kingdom.
Amen.
Ascension to your miracle.
Yes.
Ascension to your promotion.
Amen.
In Jesus' name,
Amen.
May they receive.
Receive.
Those who are in school, those who write compositions and exams through this hand, may they never fail exams in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May they prosper.
Amen.
Prosper.
Amen.
Prosper.
Amen.
Prosperity.
Amen.
Prosperity.
Amen.
You are the only person who understands the language of prosperity. You are the only being who understands the language of prosperity. You are the only being who understands the language of blessing. Now command blessing. May my Lord command blessing in this hand. I've commanded it by my reason, by my knowledge. But now I want the Lord Himself to command blessing. Bakolobasakolo paragasogolose bekaso bokolobasi. Barose bekele bakaso bokolomonose. The Lord is commanding blessing now. Bakoso bokolo boseto rohose bekesi. Bakolo bakese bekele beselo bakaso bokoso. Bakose bekele meneso bokolo bosekolose. Let me translate what I'm saying. I'm saying that all the battles, you may put your hands down, that all the battles of sickness, all financial battles, all but the battles of rejection, yes, the Lord is taking control of them. And the Lord is going to give you ease and peace. In Jesus' name. Makolo base makala baselo bole ale paraso bokoro baselo bose. Now, I surrender.
I surrender.
You want to count 1, 2, 3. Then we shout in adoration as you clap and jump for victory. Because you are going to receive your miracle. And you have received it immediately.
Amen.
Now I want to activate it through that shout in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A shout that can activate your miracle. Shout yourself out of poverty. Shout yourself out of sickness. Shout yourself out of rejection. Shout yourself out of my timing. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
1, 2, 3.